Choreography today moves vertically, horizontally, anywhere in space, with the body in straight lines, curves, in spiral, contraction, release. The terms are endless and still generating. The dancer today may be asked to do anything. Or the choreographer may say, do nothing but stay active. What is common to both is the need for training, which is multifaceted and more challenging than has ever been in the past. Both dancers and choreographers use the human body as the instrument of their work, an instrument which has rules, as primary as a heartbeat and a breath, and as absolute as gravity. Understanding and defining these elements can form a basis from which the dancer can work, whatever the specific area of dance that offers the opportunity for performance. There are parallels between dance and athletics. Like athletes, dancers must be strong, flexible. They must have speed and the ability to coordinate complex movement patterns. But dancers must also be musical. They must be able to articulate to the finest degree the musical timing, the dynamics, and the quality of movement that the choreographer requires. The other side of this is the role of the choreographer as coach.
Now hold that contraction, hips through, and from that contraction reach back into the stretch. Don't let go, contract again, forward, carry the leg with you, and pull.
Choreographers must find ways to translate their own unique physicality to the bodies of the dancers who will perform their work. To do this, they may draw from a physical source which may have inspired the choreographic idea. Or they may give technical instruction, working from their own training and background.
Now, absolute, it gets a little bit cut. You know what, I know what happens. From here, you're already going. No, keep to the front and then change.
Through this dual role of teacher-choreographer, personal styles have evolved into techniques, some at an international level. For some, dance is an exaggeration of life. For us all, to live and breathe are one. This complex process, always present in life, can be a key element of movement in space. To use this principle, the dancer must first define breathing in physical terms. As we breathe, the chest will lift breathing in and drop breathing out. Lift breathing in, drop breathing out. With the same billows like expansion and contraction, the ribs expand as we breathe in and close breathe out. Expand, breathe in, and close, breathe out. The pelvis, with the breath out of the body, is in a curved position, and with the breath in the body, a lifted position. Breathing, a rhythmic ebb and flow through the core of the body. Use the floor as an extension of your own body. First, as you stand, feel the floor, and as you begin moving, work from the floor. This simple exercise, arching and pointing the foot, can illustrate the use of the floor and its effect on movement quality. As the heel lifts, the dancer presses down through the metatarsal to the floor, thus working the arch to its limit. From the pointed position, as the metatarsal lowers, again she presses it firmly to the floor and again extends the work of the lifted arch. This lift from the floor will continue up through the legs, the torso, and out into space, pressing down, lifting up, pressing down against the floor, and lifting up out of the floor. To the dancer, space is movement. It is not where you are, it is where you want to be, and how you get there is dance. Dance is movement through space. center within the dancer is supported by what can be the powerful rectus abdominis muscle, and at the back by the erector spinae. As the dancers work to strengthen these muscles, an internal sense of alignment also develops, a plumb line through the center of the body. Endless floor exercises will also develop flexibility and quality of movement, and the ability to articulate. Spiral, an open circular movement, constantly renewing itself from phrase to phrase. It can be undulating like water, or muscular like a serpent. The inspiration and tool of the scientist, the engineer, the artist. When studied and understood, the very simple structures of center, curve, and opposition can support patterns and forms of any complexity. The beautiful, unending spiral. Opposition. In everyday life, the man running to catch the 8:15 could not make it without opposition. Or the Olympic runner stretching desperately for the finish line could never win his race without opposition, nor could he stop afterwards without it. This ability to coordinate and balance opposing elements, which we all have, in the Olympic athlete and dancer can be developed to levels which result in extraordinary physicality. Let's have another look. The gymnast on the balance beam, the runner thinking about speed in milliseconds, and the dancer reaching toward maximum extension begin here. A standing position, the body poised for motion in opposition. The left side of this dancer's torso and his left arm rotate toward the opposite right leg and foot. To project himself into space, pushing hard against the floor with the right foot will shift the right side of the torso and right arm forward, while the opposite left leg will move ahead from back to front. Continuing, the next movement, a preparation for a leap, pivots the left hip and shoulder forward in opposition to what will be the projecting foot. At the top of his jump, he will reach simultaneously toward both left and right sides, thus stretching the second position to the maximum extension. To stop momentum and change direction, the torso is thrown forward in the new direction, while the back leg in attitude position follows through in the old direction, opposition front to back. To project forward as before, the right standing foot pushes the floor, shifting the right side of the torso and right arm forward, while the opposite left leg begins to move from back to front. Finally, opposition between the pull of the body from where you've come to the reach of the body, where you want to go. What happens within the body for movements which are centered is the same as for movements which are off-center. When the dancer's strength and knowledge of his own center is absolutely secure, more advanced training can begin to develop the balance that maintains the center in off-center space. Greater strength needed to support these more extended movements also develops. The working idea is that the more off-centered the movement, the more centered you must be, will become an instinctive moving principle. The dancer's life work to develop an instrument is similar in some ways to that of the sculptor to create a form. The work for both is physical and hard. It may extend for long hours and for a long period of time. Each must mold and shape, building on a foundation and cutting away, until the final form emerges, expressive and powerful, a physical projection of an inner vision. But there are differences. The raw material of an untrained body and the tool of the daily lesson are not as substantial as the clay and dowel of the sculptor. The elements that a dancer works with are more elusive, the inner structure of a dancer's center is built on a sense as intangible and mutable as the flow of breath. In training, the awareness of essence, not substance, becomes a basis for exercises.